while since I've done like a little sit down talking video. So I wanted to do just kind of a quick one, even though every time I say quick, it's like 20 or 30 minutes. I wanted to do one about the tips and suggestions that I have for anyone else that would be doing a lap surgery for endometriosis. I wrote down, little notebook, I wrote down like a bunch of tips that I want to just kind of cover. So this week will be 8 weeks since my surgery, and I'm good, I'm doing fine. So my doctor told me that your body takes 3 full months to heal after a surgery, so I'm just about there. But I can see what he means. I can still feel inside of my tummy like a little bit of soreness every once in a while. I've quit doing ab exercises at my gym in my workout classes because I would just randomly get like sore like around the belly button area still. So I told everybody there, I'm like, I'm not doing abs anymore. Just because I don't want to slow down my healing process at all. So this video, I'm just going to talk a little bit about my tips for surgery, like before, during recovery, after recovery, just some stuff that like I was thinking about it. And so when I was preparing for my surgery, I don't know why I have a pen, I'm not going to be writing anything. So before my surgery, I was freaking out and I was Googling everything I could, trying to find all the info that I could, any tips that other people had, watching YouTube videos and everything. And I didn't really find like too much information that I feel like I actually used or that actually helped me to recover. So I was trying to think like, okay, what would be some things that I did that I didn't see when I was looking for information that I could share with someone else. So that's what I did. I just wrote down what I thought helped me. Okay, I guess I'll just get started with this list. I'm like kind of out of it today. I'm really tired for some reason. So I'm trying to like snap out of it and wake up because I haven't gone to the gym yet and I'm going this evening and I need to like wake up. I've just been working all day. Okay. So, and these are not in any specific order. They're just as I thought of them, I wrote them down. So, yeah. Okay, so let's see. My first tip on here is drink lots of water the days leading up to your surgery and then after. So, obviously, you're going to have a time frame and it's probably going to be different depending on your doctor, but there's going to be a time frame where you're not allowed to have anything to eat or any liquids before your surgery, so obviously follow your doctor's rules, but I'm talking about the days even leading up to that. So say like the week of your surgery, drink as much water as you can. I tried to do that. I didn't do as good of a job as I could, but I think that the more hydrated you are before, the more hydrated you'll be during and after. Because after surgery, I was so, so, so dehydrated. Even like in the hospital, in the recovery room after my surgery, I was so dehydrated. They had to give me some fluids before I could leave. And I just felt really bad. So I think that had I hydrated myself a little bit more before the surgery, I probably would have been in a better position. During recovery, but yeah, so just try to stay hydrated as much as you can. I kept a bottle of water, like a refillable water, with me at all times. I kept one by my bed so that if I woke up in the middle of the night, I was just drinking as much water as I could. It really made a difference in how I felt. So I just think that's important. So hydrate. Also, my skin was so dry after. Just everything needed to be hydrated. So I think the more water that you can drink before and after, the better. Okay, let's see. Here's another one. This is something I found so helpful. Like, I think that I would have been a lot more stressed out had I not done this. And I know that maybe not everybody can do this. But if you're able to sleep by yourself in your own room, I highly suggest it. I have a dog that sleeps in my room every night and a husband that I sleep with, and my husband wasn't able to take off really any work after my surgery. I didn't need him to, so it was fine. He took off the day of my surgery to take me. But so I just didn't want to be stressed out about him getting woken up in the middle of the night because I had to wake up because I knew he had to go to work and all of that. So what I did is I was lucky because I have this bed right here that I shoot my boudoir sessions on. I had him bring it downstairs and put it in a spare room that we have. And I made my own little bedroom, my own little setup, so I could just do my own thing. And I think that helped a lot. I made sure and set my alarm every time I needed to take my medication so that if I fell asleep, I wouldn't miss it, because I really think it's important to stay on top of your medication. That's another thing. I don't think I wrote that down. But yeah, staying on top of your medication, not letting it go over the time that you're supposed to have it, so that you don't feel any more pain, I think is really important. Yeah, but so I set my alarm for all of those times, and I didn't have to worry about him waking up. I got, really uncomfortable, especially the first week. Like, trying to sleep was just so frustrating and so uncomfortable, so I was moving around a lot, I was getting out of bed a lot, taking little walks, going to the bathroom. So all of that stuff is just kind of nice to be in your own space and just kind of do whatever you need to do without worrying about waking up your spouse or anything like that. So I recommend that if you can. What else? Another thing, this is probably a common one if you search online, but a heating pad is great to have. My back was really, really sore for a few days. It's kind of weird. Like, it wasn't sore right away. It was kind of like maybe into the first week, second week, it just got so, so sore. And I think it was just because I wasn't able to stand straight up when I was walking. I was still hunching over because it hurt to stand straight up. And I was just sitting down so much that my back was just killing me and trying to sleep. So yeah, a heating pad really helped with that on my back. I didn't use it as much on my stomach or my incisions as I thought I would. And I really was lucky and didn't have really that much issue with the gas traveling and the pain in the shoulder. I know that that's quite common, but I really didn't have that, so I didn't need it there. But for your back, it's really good, and even like your upper shoulders, because just all your muscles are so tense. I was looking online and I read that during surgery your body doesn't stay flat. Like, they don't, it won't necessarily stay how they put you. They kind of contort you and move you around as needed. So I think after surgery, your muscles are just like so tense and just like you could have been in like a crazy position that your body normally wouldn't be in. So that's going to be a little bit painful afterwards. So yeah. Okay. Another one are sanitary pads. After surgery, I really didn't bleed a lot. Just the first day I had quite a bit come out, like maybe once or twice, and then just like a little bit of spotting. But just the convenience of wearing like just a thin panty liner made a huge difference, because once I was in a spot sitting or laying down and comfortable, I didn't have to worry about like getting up to go to the restroom. Do you know what I mean? So I think just having like just a thin panty liner, even just to kind of keep one on kind of all the time for the first couple of days, is just something, just one more thing you don't have to worry about getting up and going to the bathroom any more than you need to, you know? So that. Okay, let's see. I guess I already kind of did say this. I didn't think I wrote this down, but setting alarm for your medication. So the medication I was prescribed, I was supposed to take it every 6 hours. So that even meant like at midnight, 6 a.m. So I made sure to set an alarm on my phone so that I never missed taking my medication. I think just as long as you stay up on it like you're supposed to and not wait too long to where you like really start feeling the pain, is good to do. So make sure to do that. And I set my alarm even during the day, just because, you know, after surgery, sometimes you get tired or you don't feel good and you might just doze off and fall asleep, and I didn't want to miss any of my medication, so I set an alarm all the time. And the prescribed medication I got, I can't remember the name of, but I also got a prescription for a stronger one. I think it was like hydrocodone or maybe hydrocodone? I think that's it, right? But I ended up, I didn't want to take that unless I absolutely had to. And I ended up not having to take that. So I think that that's because I stayed on top of my regular medication so well. And that I was just really careful with everything that I was doing so that I didn't cause myself any unnecessary pain, you know, any more pain than I already had. So I didn't need to take that. Let's see, another one. This is another pretty common one is, wear loose clothing. I wore probably the same shorts for like a month. Of course I washed them. But yeah, I just had one pair of like really loose, comfortable pajama shorts, and that's what I lived in, and baggy t-shirts. Because, I mean, if you have endometriosis, you probably already know that any tight clothing, anything restricting around your abdomen is just uncomfortable anyway, but especially after surgery, you're going to be really bloated, probably for the first week, if not a little bit longer. And then obviously you don't want anything tight around your incision sites. So something that's really loose, and not only that, if it's pants or shorts, something that sits lower on your belly, like under your belly. I didn't want anything on my belly. Like, it was just so uncomfortable. I didn't wear a bra for like, unless I absolutely had to, I didn't wear a bra at all. So just try and be as comfortable as you can and wear something loose. What else? Okay. Kind of to go along with that, for some reason, and I don't know if this is like a norm, like a common thing, or if it was just me or what. So I live in Idaho, and we're, well, almost pretty much towards the end of summer now, but I had my surgery the end of June, which is summer for us, and it was hot. I mean, we had days where it was 100 degrees, over 100 degrees. I was cold all the time after surgery. Like, probably the first 2 to 3 weeks, I was always cold. So keep, like, some warm, fuzzy, comfortable socks handy and a little sweater. That helped a lot because, you know, when you get too cold, you're like shivering, and then it like tenses up your muscles more, and it's just so uncomfortable. So I was getting so annoyed. I kept telling my husband, like, why am I just so cold all the time? Yeah, so I don't know if that was the medicine or just my healing process or what, but I always had a sweater on and socks with me. So that's another helpful tip. Okay, another one is extra pillows. I slept with probably 3 or 4 pillows, and I usually sleep with one. So extra pillows is really helpful for when you feel like you're comfortable enough to start trying to sleep on your side, you're gonna want a pillow under your belly to kind of support it. And then also I, for quite a while, couldn't sleep on my side. So I was sleeping on my back constantly. And like I said, my back was starting to really hurt. So what helped me is putting a pillow or two underneath my legs to elevate them. That helped my back. And not only that, it helped my abdomen as well, because after surgery, I don't know, like, I don't think it's just me. Oh, paper cut. I really did just give myself a paper cut. Can you see that? An actual paper cut. That's awesome. But after surgery, like, I was hunched over quite a lot when I was walking and standing and stuff. And so when you go to lay flat in bed to go to sleep, my body just wasn't used to it. And it just felt like my abdomen was just being stretched out, and that pulling just was really painful because obviously that's where I just had the surgery and it was trying to heal. And so, being able to elevate your legs instead of just like feeling like you're just laying so straight in bed was really a lot more comfortable for me. And then also there would be times in the middle of the night where I was just so uncomfortable, all I could do was like prop myself up, kind of like I am now with this pillow, against like the wall, and like kind of sit/lay for a little bit in bed. So you're gonna want extra pillows, so I think that's helpful. Even a body pillow would probably be helpful. I tried one, and I just found that regular pillows were more comfortable for me, but you might want a body pillow. I really did give myself a paper cut. Look, it's bleeding now. more of my gross nails. Wait, it's not focusing. Focus, focus, focus. Focus. It won't focus. Whatever. Right there. Can you see it? There's blood. Oh, crap. Okay, what else? Okay. Eat. All right, so this one's kind of hard because after surgery, probably at least for the first day, you're going to want to eat like very mild, very soft, easy to digest foods, like everything I read suggested, like eggs and oatmeal and Jell-O and stuff like that. It's hard to do soft foods unless it's eggs or oatmeal that isn't a ton of sugar, you know, like Jell-O and ice cream and popsicles and stuff like that. So I tried to keep a lot of fruit and vegetables around. Just because they're easy to eat, I knew it wouldn't upset my stomach, and then also you're getting all the vitamins from the fruit. So try to keep a lot of that around rather than like grabbing snacks that aren't very healthy or full of sugar, because that can upset your stomach. I was lucky and I really didn't have any digestive issues after surgery at all. I didn't get constipated. I didn't have to take any medication or anything like that for it. But I think that that's quite a common thing. So the better you eat, I think the less issue you'll have with that, hopefully. All right, what else? So there were a few things that I kept in my room next to my bed at all times. So when I was in bed and finally comfortable and able to sleep, I didn't want to move unless I had to. So obviously I would get up a couple times a night just to walk around, and then to go to the restroom, but it was so convenient, like just to have next to my bed chapstick, water, my medicine, obviously, an alarm clock or your phone to set an alarm for your medicine, and then warm socks, like I said, because if I went to sleep with them on, sometimes I'd get hot, so I was kind of constantly like taking on and off my socks, and then snacks, because I would wake up really hungry in the middle of the night, and instead of like having to try to get out of bed, which hurt, and walk all the way to the kitchen, which took, you know, a while because I had to walk really slow and it was painful, to get food. It was just nice. I kept like a fiber bar and a banana next to my bed every night too, so that I had snacks in the middle of the night and water and chapstick and medicine and just like everything that I needed. So, oh, and lotion too, because like I said, I was so dehydrated and dry. So, just to put on your hands really quick or whatever, that was helpful. Okay, what else? Okay, this is kind of an interesting one, and I know it's going to be different for everyone, because everybody's bodies are different and everybody heals differently, but before I had my surgery, my doctor told me that it would take about a week for me to be able to, like, do my normal things. Well, a week came and gone, and I was still not back to normal at all. I think that week window they give you is more of like, okay, after a week you should be able to like walk normal. That's what I think because, and bend down normal, because other than that, nothing else was normal. I couldn't walk fast. I definitely couldn't run. I definitely couldn't work out. I had shortness of breath constantly from being inflamed from when they had the tube in there. Still just, you know, just sore, you know, like you don't want to do normal things like, So really I suggest if you can, if you work and you have to do this surgery, I think 3 to 4 weeks is more the time frame that you're going to need to take off work. It took me a full month to feel, what I would say like 98% back to normal, to where I could feel like I could run, I could go to the gym, I could bend over, I could vacuum. Like I was like more me, like still maybe a little bit tender on my tummy and spots at certain times, but it definitely took a month. So if your doctor tells you a week, don't listen to them. It's going to take longer than that. And I think, what else did I write down? So kind of to go along with that, don't overdo it. Expect it to be a slow healing process and allow it to be. I tried to do a few things too soon, and I hurt myself a little bit. I tried to vacuum, and that like pushing and pulling of the vacuum hurt my ribs. So any like household chores and stuff like that, do those before your surgery, or have your spouse or whoever is helping you or whoever you're living with, have them help you, because really you don't want to be worrying about like a dirty house or, you know, straightening up the kitchen or vacuuming or anything like that. And you don't want to hurt yourself by trying to overdo it and do something sooner than you should. What else? What else? Okay, so here's another one that this is more just like a personal thing with me. I'm kind of like this anyway, to an extent. Like, I don't go crazy. Like, I definitely use products that have chemicals in them, and I like perfume that I know isn't good for you and stuff like that. But I just felt like, especially after surgery, when your body is just soaking everything in, when it's trying to heal, and when you have like open incision sites and stuff, I think that it's probably helpful to just really lessen the chemicals around you and that you're putting on yourself and your body. So if you're dehydrated like I was and you're putting on body lotion, especially around your incision sites, make sure it's something natural. What I used actually was just coconut oil and rosehip oil. Those are both really hydrating, and the rosehip oil is actually really good for scars and healing as well. So I suggest that rather than just like a regular body lotion. What else? That's kind of it on that page. Okay. So also, since you are, you know, not feeling the greatest, not looking the greatest, you're going to be cooped up in the house quite a bit. I definitely suggest to go outside a few times a day. That made me feel so much better. Just even to sit on my back porch with a cup of tea, you know, for 20 minutes. Get outside. A few times a day. But don't overdo it, and don't try to limit your exposure to the sun. Just because I feel like your body's just more sensitive, and not only that, your incision sites the scarring will be less if they're out of the sun. So try and just stay out of the sun as much as you can. Let's see, what else do I have on here? Walk slow. So I walked like a turtle for a while. But the reason I did that is because I would just test myself. Like, even just down my hallway in my house, I would walk a little faster. And, you know, the faster you walk, the more your body kind of jiggles around, and that makes your tummy uncomfortable. So if I was uncomfortable at all, I just slowed down. Even just shuffling my feet down the hall if I had to. Expect to walk slow and just allow yourself to do it. You're not in any hurry to get anywhere. You don't want to rush your body to heal, because it's going to take time. You can't make it heal any faster anyway. Okay, here's one that I didn't feel like anybody talked about this. So I am really lucky, and I have really great insurance. But when I was sitting there getting ready to go back into like the surgery, like get my surgery, you know, when they come and like take your vitals and put the IV in and all that, they ask you a bunch of questions. She asked me if I had anxiety, and I told her yes. And she asked me if I was feeling it right now, and I was like, no. Actually doing pretty good. And then my husband came in the room, and that made me get like anxious for whatever reason, I don't know. But so they offer you a bunch of medication before your surgery. They offer you anxiety medication. They'll offer you, like, if you have a headache, they'll give you something for that. I kind of just was like yes to everything, because I was worried I was going to get a headache, because I knew I was going to be dehydrated. And I was worried I was gonna like freak out with my anxiety, so I said yes to that. Anyway, what I'm getting at here is, especially if you don't have insurance, don't just say yes to everything. Ask them if they're gonna charge you for it and how much, because they will charge you for every single little thing. They charge you for, everything, obviously. I mean, you probably already know that, especially if you've had a surgery. It's a hospital, they charge for everything. So if there's any medication that they offer you that you don't need, just don't accept them, because you're just going to end up paying for it anyway. Let's see, what other tip? Okay, I think this is probably my last one. And then I've pretty much covered everything. So my last one is, if you are like me and you work out, you know, 4 to 6 times a week, make sure that you aren't trying to rush yourself into going back to working out or going to the gym. I actually did really well and I didn't do that, but once I was able to go, I went to my regular classes and everybody knew what was going on, so they knew that I was going to be taking it easy. I went really slow with everything we were doing, anything. I mean, even if it was just like doing our biceps or something, like I used light weights, I went slow because I was just trying to kind of feeling out my body, seeing how things felt, seeing if I could breathe. And what I found out was that I wasn't ready really to be there. You know, I've been working out really consistently for over a year. I mean, I worked out before then, but I mean like hardcore classes. But you would think that working out that long like that you would recover faster. You don't, and you won't. It doesn't matter how healthy you are, how fit you are, your body still needs a certain amount of time to heal and to get back to normal, and you just need to allow it. So when I went back to the gym, I just realized, like, okay, that long of working out and like 3 weeks just knocked me down. Like, I had never worked out a day in my life. Like, I couldn't breathe. I could hardly lift weights. I just had no, like, energy. I had no endurance. My strength was just completely gone. My muscles were just so weak, you know, from just sitting around, and I just felt so weak, I guess is the way to explain it. And then my breathing really took a long time to get back to normal. I would say that full month for sure. Yeah, so don't rush yourself into it. Just wait, because it's more important for your body to heal and for you to be feeling good. You don't want to slow down the healing process, and you can work out at any time afterwards once you're feeling good, you know. So yeah, so that was my tips for kind of what I found helped me before, during, after surgery, up until like now. Hopefully my tips will help somebody else that is going to get this surgery, and if you have to get it, I feel for you, because honestly I don't ever want to do that again. If I have to, I will, maybe. But I really don't want to. Okay, I think that's it. Now I'm gonna go work out. Don't fall. Okay, this video sucks balls. Are you down there? Babe, stop, I'm almost done. Oh, okay, thanks. Crap, now I don't remember what I was saying. Hi, no. Anyway. No, I hate the way I'm talking. I'm uncomfortable.